Everyone, we wanted to come in here and just talk to you guys a little bit more about emotional eating because it's for real. It's one of the things that a lot of people deals with today, and there is an underlying issue. So we want to talk about those things when it relates to food addictions, because what are the foods that we run to when things are not going our way, when things in life are not happening like we expect them to, or when, you know, we're going through things in life? Most people run to that food that they love, or that food that they feel like makes them feel much better.
It's a feeling. It's I feel this way. Mm. I feel hungry. Wow. I feel like I need to go get this particular quick fix. Mm. You know, it's a feeling. Mm. So we want to bring this awareness to you that sometimes these feelings may not be the best, may not be in your best interest. Mm-hmm. We're talking about food addiction. So the addiction is meeting an actual, need, but it's a quick fix need. So we really want to bring to your awareness of your life. What's really at matter here? And I know sometimes when you be caught up in a moment, you know, when certain things hit you, and you know, you just automatically think of a certain way or a certain feeling, you automatically go do what you've been doing in the past and not really thinking about your life because you caught up in the moment. So we really want you to grasp what really at hand here. What are we really talking about?
So there is underlying issues. Like, there are things that are happening in our lives, but we run to, and I say we, because that used to be one of the things that I would do. Like, if I'm not feeling a certain way or things are not going the way that I expect them to go, or I want them to go, I ran to ice cream, cake, cookies, those things that I thought made me feel better, but it never really addressed the issue. And those things that are really happening in our lives, instead of us trying to cover it up with the food, are thinking that the food is going to make it all better, we need to truly run to the source who is able to help us through those things. And that is no other than our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He is the one who is able to help us to get through those issues. He is the one to help us to, you know, gain peace in our lives. You know, he is the one to help us through those issues. So we have to learn to more depend on him than depending on that food to make us feel better. Because it's like Eugene said, it's only a temporary fix. It's not something that's going to be there forever. So we have to realize that there is an underlying cause, and then we have to address that underlying cause by taking it to the one who can help us. That's truly the only one that can help us. That's truly the only one that can help us through whatever it is that we may be going through. It's a process. It's a process. We're not saying that it's going to happen overnight. But of course, taking on those three steps that we talked about at the very beginning, acknowledging that there is an issue, you know, and then going after, like, setting yourself up for success and then going after that thing, but having steps in place. And that means including God, including him in this process as well, because he is a big part of the process, because there are some addictions that we won't be able to get over on our own. There are just some things that we are going to need our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, on.
And the love of money is the root of all evil. And I mean, and you cannot be aware today. I mean, you just cannot be, on social media, in the news. I mean, we hear all the time about certain foods, and you hear lawsuits, and you hear recalls on certain foods. Even some of our kids, they're starting to realize about certain campaign ads and things like that, how they would see how food's really not good. Certain foods, they have ingredients in it. I mean, it's so much talk about certain things. So we know this. We are aware of this. And so what we really want you to think about what's really at matter in your life. And it's a spiritual warfare. The root of all evil is the root of all evil is the love of money. So it's certain addictions, it's certain things that these food makes us feel a certain way because of wickedness, because of how these corporations and certain things have have elaborated these foods to help create this feeling, this mood that's really not real, that's not true. It's not you. It's not how God created us to think, to feel, to go run to certain things, get this quick fix. No. So you're going to have to be in prayer. You have to go be asking God to help you through this. I mean, some addictions like it's just so real to your body that you cannot do it by yourself. And you can't do it by us being as health coaches. It's only by God's grace and his mercy. So this is what really at store here. Your soul, your life, your mind, how you think, you, your life is at hand. So we just really want you to think what's really going on.
Absolutely. So we just wanted to come in here and we want you guys to know that, you know, if you did, you know, slip up and you ate this or if, you know, whatever, we're not here to judge you. We're here to help you get back on track. But we're also here to let you know that we are not the know-it-alls. Like, you have to take it to God. Like, he is the one that is going to help us through. He's going to help us to win this war on food addiction, guys. But we just wanted to come in here and just give you guys just a quick video on emotional eating and just really attacking the issue, the true issue at hand, because it's not just, you know, getting that satisfaction by just eating that food, but it's something underlining that is going on. All right, guys, you have an awesome day.